to you all. We shall continue with the flower. In the previous class, we had discussed about the floral whorls, that is calyx, corolla, endosium and gynosium. This flower, you are very familiar with it. It is commonly called as China rose. Botanical term is Hibiscus rosa sinensis. You can see, as we had discussed in the previous class, the part of the by which we hold the flower is called as pedicel. Then we have the calyx. Here I had discussed about camo sepals, that is the sepals are united. I had also discussed that there is an extra whorl of calyx which is called as epicalyx. So let me show you. So since when we had discussed about the calyx, calyx is the outermost floral whorl. Function is to protect the inner floral whorls during bud stage. See, this is what we refer as gamosepals. Clear? The sepals are united. Next comes the second inner floral whorl, that is the petals. The petals are free. They are not united. So in this condition, it is said as polypetalous or corolla. They are brightly colored. Why? To attract insects for pollination. So when you do the flower dissection, first you have to remove the calyx, then describe, first you have to describe about the flower. Calyx, then we have the corolla. The third inner floral whorl are the stamens or the endosium. As you can see here, there are number of filaments. These filaments are united into a single bundle. Therefore, they are called as monodelphous. Clear? The anthers, when you observe under the dissecting microscope, they are bilobed and they have a very thin filament by which they are attached. The anther lobe and the filament collectively or together, they are called as stamens. The anther, what is lobe? What is their function? They produce large number of pollen grains which form the male gamete. Now, the innermost floral whorl are the gynosium, also known as pistil. Now, when you observe the flower, what I said, the flower has bisexual or hermaphrodite because it contains calyx, corolla, endosium and gynosium. Now, the gynosium consists of stigma, style and ovary. Let me show you. You have to remove the outer staminal tube. Then the innermost part which you will be observing it. When you go to in your practical class also, you have this flower dissection. You will be given a flower and you will be asked to separate out the different floral whorls. So as you can see, this is the stigma, style and ovary. Let me take it out. They are sticky and in most of the colorful flowers, you find that they have got an extra structures called as nectaries which are present at the base. So, you have the stigma, style and ovary. Stigma, you can see they are five. They act as the landing surface for to receive the pollen grain. The pollen grain sit, that is they are transferred by the insects, and when they fall on the stigma, the pollination occurs. Now, among the anthers, only one or two male gamete, that is the pollen grain, they germinate. They form a pollen tube and move through the style. Clear? So this is the stigma, style and ovary. So as you can see here, the style is a slender tube, tubular in structure. What is their function? They carry the pollen grain or the male gamete towards the ovary. As I show you, this is stigma, style and ovary. Upside down, it is will be more clear. Stigma, style and ovary. Now, this swollen portion which you observe, that is the thalamus or receptacle or torus that supports the all floral walls. Next, you find that is the ovary. It is formed at the base and it contains many female gametes called as ovules. They are attached to a structure called as placenta. So what are the ovules? These are the female gametes. Let me show you. You have to prepare a slide, as I cannot show prepare a slide here, but I can show you the presence of the ovules. See, the ovules, the whitish structure which you observe are the eggs or the ovules which form the female gamete, and they are attached to a structure called as placenta. So the arrangement of the ovules in the placenta is called as placentation. Clear? There are many types of placentation: basal placentation, parietal, free central. That is not in the syllabus at present, where you will be studying more in detail in higher classes. Just if you are asked what is placentation, the manner in which the ovules are arranged in the placenta of the ovary is called as placentation. Clear? Now there are certain other terms that you will be studying. That is bract. Now what is bract? You are very familiar with bougainvillea. Now when the flower arises in the axil of a leaf-like structure, it is called as bract. So when you observe the bougainvillea, at present I cannot show you, but you find it very commonly. That is the colored part. It is not the petal actually. It is the bract. So sometimes when the flower has got only stamen, it is called as staminate. When it has got only the female part, it is also called as pistillate. Clear? Now, as I said, I have already mentioned about the nectaries. What are nectaries? These are nectar secreting cells present at the base of the flower. Clear? So they produce nectar which attract the insects and the honeybees. Like honeybees, birds, they come to seek nectar, suck nectar, and then they help in pollination. Clear? Now the next important topic is about inflorescence. What is inflorescence? The manner in which the flowers are arranged on the floral axis. Clear? Now there are two types, I'll tell you. These are racemos. Let me draw the diagram first. Just a rough diagram. Clear? You have the side branches. Clear? What is inflorescence? Inflorescence is the manner in which the flowers are arranged on the floral axis of the stem or the branches. In racemos, what happens? The main floral axis does not end in a flower, while the lateral branches, what do you mean by lateral branches? This is referred as terminal branches. Clear? This does not end in flower. It grows continuously. But the lateral branches, they develop flower. How is it? In acropetal succession. Acropetal succession means what? The branches, the lower branches will develop the flower first, the lowermost. Clear? Then the other branches. This type of arrangement of the flower is called as racemos inflorescence. There is another type which is called as cymos. Now in the cymos, just a rough diagram, I'll show you.
What happens in the cymose inflorescence?
The main axis ends in a flower. Clear? Now, just the opposite. Here we had the acropetal section. Here it is the basipetal arrangement of the flowers. Now what happens? In this case, the main axis, floral axis, ends in a flower, and the lateral branches, the uppermost branches, will bear flowers first. First this one, then this one, then this, then this. That means the lower branches will have flowers which develop later, while the uppermost branches will develop flower first. Just the opposite of racemos. Clear? So I hope you have understood the flower chapter clearly. If you have any doubts, children, you can write to me, Ganoshyam, stigma, style, and ovary. It is also called as pistil. It may contain carpels, monocapillary 1, bicapillary 2, tricapillary 3, or polycapillary mini carpels. They can be fused, then they are termed as syncarpus. If the carpels are free, they are called as apocarpus. The arrangement also, how they are arranged, the ovary are arranged on the thalamus. It can be epigynous, perigynous, and hypogynous. Flowers, if they develop on the both, the flowers are present on the same plant, dioecious and monoecious. Some technical terms that you should know. These are just a few technical terms. As you go to higher classes, you will be studying more about it. So next you have this one. Just a minute, let me arrange the flowers. Staminate flower, pistillate flower, monoecious flower, dioecious flower, presentation, and inflorescence. Cymose inflorescence. I want to just show the flower again, different parts, how they are arranged in the same page. See, as I said, let me write here. This is the calyx. These are the petals or corolla. Five. So petals five, pentapetalous, corolla. This also sepals are five, united, gamosepalous. Just a minute. Don't get agitated. Then this is polypetalous. Different parts. Then you have this Staminal tube, the stamens. Got it? This arrangement is called as these are the antelope and filament. This whole thing is staminal tube, referred as monadelphus, found in hibiscus. When the stamens, that is the filaments, are arranged in one bundle. Clear? Then lastly, you have the innermost floral wall, stigma, has become sticky here. Style and ovary. So ovary, I have already shown you this part. Ovary and pedicel. Clear? Just see. So that is all for this particular class. Stay home, be safe.